Let's look at finding the domain of a fractional function involving radicals. First, we need to remind ourselves when there is a restriction on the domain. The two situations that result in a restriction on the domain are when there's a variable in the denominator or there's a radical. So, if there's a variable in the denominator, we know that we cannot have the denominator equal zero. It cannot equal zero. So any values of the variable that would result in the denominator equaling zero will be restrictions. The second situation that occurs that creates a restriction on the domain, is when we have a square root symbol with a variable inside it. Whatever is in here is called the argument. And the argument has to be greater than or equal to zero. Because remember, if we take the square root of a negative number, we end up with an imaginary number. Okay? So let's look at a few examples. Here we have a radical and a square root. So let's deal with the radical first. We need x minus 3 to be greater than or equal to 0. So x will be greater than or equal to 3. Next, let's deal with the denominator. 2x minus 8 cannot be 0. So 2x cannot be 8. X cannot be 4. Now we're going to put these values on a number line. So here's a number line, and my 4 is an open circle because it can't be equal. My 3 is a closed circle because it can be equal, and it's greater than, so it would go over here to the right. To write this in interval notation, it would be from 3 to 4, union 4 to infinity. We had to break it at 4 because of that open circle. Let's look at another one. Here again, we have a radical and a denominator. So let's look at the radical. We need x plus 6 to be greater than or equal to 0. So x has to be greater than or equal to negative 6. Now looking at the denominator, negative 3x plus 9 cannot be equal to 0. So negative 3x cannot be equal to negative 9. So x cannot be equal to, positive 3. Now let's put that stuff on a number line and see what it looks like. At positive 3, I'm going to have an open circle because we cannot have that value. And then I have a negative 6, which will have a closed circle and go to the right because it's greater than. So my interval is negative 6 to 3, union 3 to infinity. Again, we had to break it at the 3 because of the open circle. Let's look at a different situation. Here, we have a radical and a denominator all at the same time. So we're going to have to think about this a little bit differently, because not only do we need this part to be greater than or equal to 0, it actually can't be equal to 0 because that would give us a 0 in the denominator. So this results in we need 4 plus x to be greater than 0, which means we need x to be greater than negative 4. And that's it. Those are actually pretty easy, right? So my interval would be negative 4 to infinity. Looking at another one like that, here, we do have a variable in the numerator, but since there's no radical and that's not a fraction in the numerator, we don't have to pay any attention to that variable at all. In the denominator, we have the radical. So when the radical's in the denominator, we need the argument, or whatever is inside that radical, to be greater than 0. We can't do greater than or equal to zero like we did in the beginning because we can't have a zero in the denominator. So that means that x has to be greater than 8. And so my interval would be 8 to infinity. One more type. Here, we have a big radical, right? The radical's over the whole thing. So we're going to have a very similar situation to the ones we just did. We can't have a zero in the denominator. So that means that 7 over x plus 7 has to be greater than 0, right? So this is going to happen because the 7 is positive in the numerator. This is going to be true whenever x plus 7 is greater than 0. In this first one, we could have done the greater than or equal to 0, I guess, but x plus 7 has to be greater than 0 because if it's equal to 0, that gives me a 0 in the denominator. So x would be greater than negative 7, and my interval would be negative 7 to infinity. Last one, same situation. We have the big radical, and so what we are looking at is 8 over x plus 5 has to be greater than or equal to 0. This is going to happen when x plus 5 is greater than 0 because the 8 is positive. We know that anything that's going to change the sign of the value there to be sure that we don't have a negative in the radical is going to happen in the x plus 5. And the x plus 5 has to be greater than, not greater than or equal to prevent having a 0 in the denominator. So x would be greater than negative 5, and in interval notation, that is negative 5 to infinity. I hope you found this helpful.